simple point is all this comes down to this. We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
When you ask what makes us the greatest country in the world, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
We're told that Americans have the best lives of any people in the world. That we have low taxes, small government, and the highest living standards on earth. And most inaccurately, that we're the freest.
Welcome to the decline of the American Empire.
Very nice words, but happens to be wrong.
Ladies, gentlemen, and compound fans, it's America's birthday, and if you got red, white, and blue balls, well, you can be ready to America-come. Here we go with our interns. Not interns anymore, though. Bobby Tamburo and Lumi Popovich.
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Oh, no, baby.
Yes, baby. I get it, a foreigner hosting a 4th of July special, I know. What were we thinking? But I worked very hard to get here. I escaped home, rode a donkey, swam here, embarrassed my family, never saw them again. But it was all worth it, because we were doing this amazing show.
That's right, we're back like a bad case of herpes. And just like herpes, hopefully this is less painful and goes faster than the last time. What better way to represent America on this holiday than having the epitome of white privilege carry a goddamn immigrant through another one of these fucking games?
Oh,
of course.
And now you guys know the rules. It's very simple. We got 5 physical challenges, 5 rounds of trivia. We'll see who knows the most about the United States. Now, let's meet our teams.
So does Luby not get paid?
I never got paid. Forever intern.
Seems like she works so hard. I'm like, wait a second, they're not paying us.
Don't tell her.
I'm too stupid to notice. Why did you do this?
So much exposure coming at you from every dick.
All right. Speaking of Ryan Long, Team 1 is Team Canada, Team Immigrants, however you want to call them.
Ooh,
yes. The most beautiful thing about America is America welcomes everyone.
Well, thank you very much for having us, and we are very happy to be here. Oh, Canada, but not too hard.
All right.
To balance out the Canadian powerhouse that is Aaron Berg and Ryan Long, we've got the most American man I can think of. Because for me, one of the best parts of the America is the American dream. You know, one day you could be a tin knocker, and the next day you could be owning a media empire. So please put together your hands together for Anthony Cumia, my best friend.
He doesn't know your name.
And next to Anthony, we've got so much personality in Steve DeGod Conti. Guys, thank you for coming. Anthony, I know your
history. I made it, guys.
I know your history.
I'm here.
Sorry, I was a little late. Thanks, buddy. Thanks for keeping it warm.
Wait, what's going on here?
Don't take this
from What a spontaneous moment of comedy.
Oh, this seems like a bit.
My name's up next to his.
This team is too dago. Bring in the German.
Anthony, I hung out with Steve all day because I know how your partners typically don't show up for games.
How dare you, Ryan?
Oh, no. See, I didn't hear that.
Yeah, what?
What did you say?
I hung out with Steve all day because
he heard you.
Usual, we get no respect. So let's move to team number three. If I learned anything in America is that sex appeal sells. Team number three, team sex appeal. Put your hands together for Dave Temple and Jennifer Eckhart. We're clapping for ourselves.
Yeah.
Boo.
Of course, America, Wakanda forever.
Of course, you know, I'm against everything I see in this frame.
Women but and blacks.
And I also a little bit thought we were team sex appeal, kind of in the
back. No.
But that was my bad. I'm sorry.
As promised.
One of the best ways to experience American culture is through our music. One of the best ways to experience our music is through concerts. And to be honest, the best way to experience a concert is too fucked up to remember it. And the best way to do that is by pre-gaming in the parking lot. Our first physical challenge is the parking lot pre-game. But before we do that, let's bring in our physical challenge specialists. Guys, if you want to come on in.
Physically challenged specialists.
Yes, to be more precise.
Mayor Lee.
Like
Nate Marshall.
Yeah.
Stevie Lou, Mike O'Donnell.
Oh, there shit.
There you go, Stevie.
Look at the mayor, big old stunt cock.
Yes.
Mr. Adams, you rang.
And to introduce our physical challenge, we've got our physical challenge host, Manny Santiago.
Yeah.
Crazy diversity.
Can I talk now?
Yeah. Please. Okay. We would love that.
All right, you guys ready for the first challenge?
Yeah.
Hell yeah. This is the parking lot pregame. In this challenge, each team must consume the following: 2 beers, 2 shots, and a joint. First team to finish wins. Pretty self-explanatory.
Wow.
The whole joint. Wow. That joint. Okay. That's a thick joint.
Wow, with the joint.
I don't drink.
That's a big one.
Shots.
Lemire, how many
big
beers
joint.
And 2 shots in a joint
Give
can you
two
drink?
2 shots and a beer.
The big okay. joint.
So that is big.
This is
those are shots.
What the fuck is this?
These are not shots.
This is a drink.
This is a.
Give me 1 shot.
This is a shot.
I'll take a shot.
Of what?
I can. This I can. 2 shots.
These are glasses of wine.
Your Americans are pussies, no?
No, but like, is
what? What is
my country? This is no shot. This is baby juice.
What are you doing?
Babies take shots in kindergarten.
That's your best.
It's good. It's good.
It's oregano, Jennifer. If anyone asks.
Can we start?
Take a shot okay.
for me.
Go.
Wait, who's?
All right.
Are we going?
Hold on. Where's
yeah, we're going.
Well,
I don't think it's a.
Here.
Is it a timed event? Where's our joints?
Hold on, people are starting. Yeah, let's go, fuck it.
Baby Lou always wins. It's unbelievable. Okay. All right, drink's done.
All right, that's a
all on you, man.
That's not a shot.
All of this is me.
That was juice.
Phil!
Dude!
Help!
Jennifer.
Oh, okay.
I find that hard to
as a reporter, you should have asked me better questions about what this entails.
I do ask questions, and you know what they say? There's nothing to prepare. Yeah. Just come. Just yeah. wing it. That's what they say.
Smoke the joint.
You said you had a tough day, and that's why we're here. You said you want a drink. That's why I'm here. I'm getting a contact high just being here in this room.
One of these started hallucinating.
Might as well just put us all in a car on a freeway.
Jump, Garrett.
I'm coming back to get you, Bob.
Bill, what I can't wait for is when my future employer pulls this video up when I'm applying for a job.
I think it's funny that you think you're going to have a future employer.
Right now, I know. Right,
it's
right.
It's me that almost killed right. Bob.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, beer is
done. Shots are done.
Shots are done. Beer's done.
Do we have a second beer? Or?
Do we have a second beer or no?
One's done.
Stevie Lou is an animal.
Second beer.
Yeah, here.
You want a shotgun?
I inhaled.
By the way, I'm not partaking in any of this. I know you keep flipping the camera on me.
Hey, does this can smoke cigars in here tonight?
I don't know if I want to help.
Only if they're loaded with weed.
It's not part of the challenge. No.
Beers are done.
I'd be disappointed if you didn't.
Hey.
Stevie Lou, don't eat the can.
This joint.
Don't. Of course. Of course.
Don't or do eat the can?
Not, please.
Yeah. Yeah. Dave's intern finishes the whole joint. He promises to learn his name.
Yeah. Holy shit.
I don't know. I don't even know who won.
Bobby, this is very fun so far. Good job.
How big's the joint?
Keep going. You're not done yet. I see the joint there.
I think the joint is like the whole thing right now.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
I'm foaming from the mouth, from the beer. Warm Budweiser just.
You know what's our joint?
It froths up like a mad dog.
Our beers are done. Our shots are done.
These joints are very fat.
Just hot rocket it. No, you know hot rocket when you go like this, you go.
I think I feel like we are getting suffocated, so it's
feels like good weed.
Dude, we're pretty fucking
high again.
Warm Budweiser remind me of
Anthony. High, but not even
your pool water.
Yes, very warm.
This is like
they look pretty good.
When they started taking hard hits at the donkeys.
Let's wrap this up.
Nice. You guys, holy shit.
No.
This is close.
All right, what do we got left, Dave? Show me what you got. How much you got left?
Bullshit.
Oh, man.
I'm going to put this event.
All right, team one.
Done joint.
I'm going to put this event on my resume.
We have an alligator clipper.
Ferguson recovery. All right.
Yeah. This is terrible.
I'm in five.
That's fine.
Four. Three.
Woo!
And that's the end of the first physical challenge. While we give our scorekeeper some time to tally the scores, Aaron, how are you feeling?
Me?
Yeah.
I'm feeling pretty good. I'm aware that there's marijuana smoking here. I did not take any alcohol, but our physical guys did most of the heavy lifting on that round.
I heard you asking about cigars
that's
earlier.
Trudeau in his outfit. So.
Yeah. What'd you say?
That was pretty good.
I liked it.
I smoked a fucking...
All right, let's go to our scorekeeper, Andy Malafarina, for an update.
Shit.
Third place, we have Team Personality. Second place, Team Sex Appeal. And first place, God damn it, the Knuckleheads.
Oh, God damn it.
God damn it.
Yeah, well. Gotta give it to the Canadians.
I did see this coming because still one.
We're smoking the other team's joint. They didn't finish.
Yeah. What a sorry state of affairs for fucking Canada wins our 4th of July.
We got the best win, guys.
All right, well, Canada's ahead now.
No, the first event.
They certainly aren't known for knowing American music. Let's go to our first category, which is American music.
Hey, do we do push-ups and shit?
All right, we're going to start with the first...
I have a cold beer to wash that warm beer down with. Holy fuck. That stunk on ice. I wish it stunk on ice. It stunk on fucking... It's warm.
We both got up on that, by the way.
Yeah,
we both got up.
You a beer.
And then we saw Garrett.
You guys are the fucking
host. Then we saw Garrett. It's just muscle memory, I guess.
I just saw it. No, I just saw it.
So Garrett is bringing the beer, which is awesome.
Garrett.
No.
Garrett is nervous.
Garrett
warned me
earlier. That's America.
Bank and winning the cup.
Nothing more American.
Team Garrett wins. Okay.
Love it.
Let's go with the first question of this portion, you guys.
So for this, write down your answer, and then we'll go and see who got it right.
Oh, cool.
I'm high. You want me to write shit?
Jennifer, we're counting on you to write.
Who can write?
I never learned.
Okay.
What do we got?
Oh, first question is...
Yeah, that's easy.
Bullshit how easy that is.
Okay, so Eminem's 8 Mile was named after a road in which American city? Atlanta, Brooklyn, Compton, or Detroit?
Come on.
What racist answers that are wrong? I don't see Roslyn Heights up there.
Do we show our answer?
All right, everybody ready? We'll go to Aaron first. What do you have?
What?
What's your answer?
We had the proper answer, which is D, Detroit.
Okay.
Team Personality, what do you guys have?
It's so cold in the day.
Yeah. Voice.
I wrote that.
Yeah, you did, of course.
Okay, Sex Appeal, let's see your answer.
Yeah. What?
Wow. Sexy yet slow. All right.
Sexy and slow. D.
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 Yeah.
D.
All right.
All right, let's go to the answer.
Triple D's, get it?
Yeah.
Thank you.
The battery.
Detroit.
All right, this was an easy one.
We all win.
This one, everybody gets a point, I guess. Bobby?
As far as big musical performances go.
I thought Detroit was in Canada.
You win. Very close.
Michigan has been annexed.
Very close. Which, I wouldn't be surprised some Canadians been waxed from fucking Detroit bullets.
That is the number one when we used to tour. That's the number one you get your car broken into city. Every band, it was a known thing. Don't put your fucking van on the streets. It disappears.
A little trivia here, too. Who was in a movie called Detroit Rock City?
I know who.
Me!
Yeah. Aaron Berg, yeah! That's right, goddammit.
Aaron Berg.
Thank you for your service, Aaron.
I'll be seeing an alarm commercial. Yeah.
Where I
playing
break
a criminal. Stop.
All right. As far as American musical performances go, more eyes don't get on a performance than the Super Bowl's halftime show. Which Super Bowl halftime show performer was upstaged by a dancing shark?
Oh, come on.
A, Lady Gaga. B, Katy Perry. C, Prince. Or D, Adam Levine.
This should be easy.
Mary's got the inside
scoop. All right.
I'm not going to let you look at this, though.
Yeah, that's, I thought that one.
Yeah, I
get it. All right, looks like everybody's ready.
Yeah, I vaguely remember.
Jennifer, we'll go to you first. What do you have?
Katy Perry.
All right.
Yeah. What do you guys have?
Left Shark. She was upstaged by the Left Shark.
Wow.
That would have been a better question. What's was it the Left Shark or the Right Shark? Because there were two sharks.
Ah, for bonus, this is Katy Perry playing in the background.
Oh, shit.
This is Miley Cyrus.
Sit down, Canada. Sit down.
Wow. Steve Perry.
It's Miley Cyrus.
Aerosmith.
Aaron, what do you have?
Miley Cyrus.
Our answer is the girl I fucked, Katy Perry.
Yeah.
Everyone.
God bless Canada.
Anthony, I'm expecting you to have the same answer. What did you guys have?
Nothing. We didn't have a good answer.
Katy Perry.
You knew this the whole time, Steve. You love Katy Perry.
Fucking tits.
Yeah. Yep.
All right, let's go to the answer. It's Katy Perry. You guys all got that.
Oh, yeah.
That was easy, actually. I already thought so.
If I knew we had the availability of all these cool graphics, I'd step my show up. Jesus. Oh, fuck. Would you guys buy something?
I mean, that eagle.
I didn't get a graphics record.
That eagle transition?
Yeah.
That was. Yeah.
That eagle. What am I, Rockefeller?
Oh my. All right, question
hey,
number
Gomez? What do you think this is? Gas Digital?
Moving on to question number three. All right. Who is the only country star with a top 20 hit on the Billboard country charts for six straight decades?
Ooh.
Is it
decades?
Yes, I know. Decade. George Strait, Willie Nelson, Dolly Parton, or Johnny Cash?
Oh my God.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see.
We should have the advantage here. I
know.
Oh my God.
If anyone, Anthony's gonna know this.
I got it.
Alright. Oh, it looks like Team Personality's having a difficult time.
No jobs and no cash.
Surprisingly, LaMare's the one giving the advice on the answer on this one. That's not who I would have picked.
Hey, the Staten Island team doesn't know it?
Alright, we'll go with you.
If not, it's Joe.
He's a worse hat. Hammer Cypher.
I don't know Zyma that well. I've only seen him do his like two man.
I don't know.
It's probably gonna be easy,
and then we'll go fog.
All right, Anthony, you guys ready?
Yeah, we'll go.
All right, let's. Who
Anthony,
wants to
Anthony, you guys ready?
Jennifer, let's start with you. You look ready.
Okay. Well, I don't know. We don't know if we're correct or not.
We're gonna start with Jennifer. Aaron, you ready?
Yeah. Longer than you.
I don't know. We think it's B or C. We think it's Dolly Parton, but we're going to go with Willie Nelson.
Willie Nelson, Team Personality, what's your answer?
There seemed to be a lot of debate on your team.
Okay. Well, were they right? I might change mine.
Nope.
Funny how we're doing this.
Hello. I'm Johnny Cash.
Answers.
Johnny Cash.
Aaron Berg, the biggest country music fan in the room. What's the answer?
B.
Let's go to the answer.
Aaron are just talking shit about people forgetting it.
It's Dolly Parton.
Son of a bitch. Son of a bitch.
Look, we fucked it up!
I
should've. Oh, wow. Three of my jokes.
You're good.
Does it again.
How did I not vote for big fucking tits?
Fucking titties!
Damn it!
What was
you
the song?
An asshole!
The biggest tits on the board are the answer we go with from here on.
What was the song?
I am the only girl on this panel.
What was
stupid?
The song?
Here we go again?
I don't know all six. There.
Yeah,
they're not answering
right. No. Okay, question number four.
9 to 5?
All right, final question in this round. Final question. Everybody ready? Aaron, ready?
Let's go.
Is that like a hairy pussy? I like a pussy that looks like the floor of a black barber shop.
All right.
You changed Martin Luther King to a different holiday.
Jesus.
I like a pussy that looks like you dropped a clump of Hubba Bubba into where they shear sheets.
I like a pussy that looks like they've been donating cancer hair.
It'd be cute if we could move on to the fourth, but I'm just suggesting. Please.
Jennifer is still worried about a resume.
What's more American than a woman ruining the fun? Am I right, Anthony?
Oh, hell yeah.
Fuck. All right. Yeah,
that positive
me?
Note.
Again?
What year was Don McLean's hit song, American Pie, released?
This is all you.
1970? 1971? Two or three?
Don McLean fan, no?
Don McLean. Wow, they are close in the years here.
Oh, boy.
That could be anything.
I mean, yeah, this.
If this was the year Mannix premiered, I'd have the answer.
The same. LeBaire's got the inside scoop again.
Decades, and I could guess that way. I don't have a guessing chance.
Oh, you're just
counting.
That's just counting.
That's
pretty good.
Are you debating too? Are you debating walking out?
I can't hear what you're saying.
Are you debating walking out? I can see it in your eyes.
No, no, no. I'm going to ride this.
Bets on whether or not Dave and Jen get it right.
I want my girl to win.
I'm going to go.
1990.
Isn't that asshole Canadian?
What's the over-under on Dave and Jen not getting this one?
Okay, let's see the answer, you guys.
Jennifer. And what do you got?
Okay, we're
our answer
gonna go with,
is
we're going to go with
1972.
1972. C. Oh, no, excuse me, Canada.
Sorry.
Down, Canada.
Sorry.
They should get a penalty. Canada gets a penalty.
And the answer is
Wow.
Sorry.
The answer is B.
Yes!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, Steve, dude. Good job, bro.
Picking up patterns. Yeah. No.
You
no,
knew
picking
that?
Picking up patterns.
He's Rain it. Man. He knows what. He's counting cards.
I love it.
He's not even reading the questions.
You're over here. Come on, dude.
He's fucking picking up a pattern, I think.
All right, let's move on to the next question. That's the final question for this round. Which American singer performed the best?
Oh, there's no multiple choice.
Which American singer performed the best-selling worldwide single of all time?
All right.
Which American singer performed the best-selling worldwide single of all time?
Thank you for an English, Bobby.
Dude, I might have.
I find it very offensive.
Where's the multiple fucking choice? What is this?
It's
Pitbull. What is this shit?
It's Pitbull. My teammates say it's
Pitbull. This is
why we
separate the men from the boys.
Mr. Worldwide.
The best-selling worldwide
single. It's either Pitbull or Michael Jackson.
Do we even get like a male or female category? Or?
No, all right.
No, it's Michael Jackson.
Bad baby. Bad baby.
Michael Jackson?
Gucci flip-flops.
Worldwide single of all time.
I kind of want to help out.
Can we get a hint? Can we phone
it? There you go.
Give us a hint. Give us a hint. Give us a hint.
I'd love a hint.
Just write.
Phone a friend.
Fucking Jackson. The guy, everything that came out of his mouth was gold except for tiny penises.
But all right. You got a point.
They were gold. He only took white children. They love American country music in every other country.
I gotta say.
Do you guys need more time, or should we?
Worldwide.
Could be Limp Bizkit.
We're going to go to you last, Aaron. You look confident.
Nickelback. Nickel, guys, it's Nickelback. It's
Violent
Nickelback.
Day.
Not Nickelback, Jennifer. That's your favorite band.
I'm sticking with this. I got it.
Okay, Jennifer.
Hey.
Do you have an answer ready?
Michael Eats Kids Butts Jackson.
Ooh, good guess.
All right.
Well, Aaron,
what do you have?
Is that what the E stood for?
Yeah. Everyone here went for he thought it was MJ,
dude,
too.
Everyone picked MJ.
I think it's gotta be.
Can we change ours?
Sure.
Michael Blackson.
Let's go to the answer.
Comedy album, yeah.
What is that?
Obama?
Answer is
White Christmas.
Come on!
Christmas, guys!
What year is this?
Weird trivia.
What year is this?
It seems to be a
bullshit.
It seems to be a theme on this network.
That ends the round music.
It was number one in 1955, Mark!
That's your torture.
You need to go to the projects and find your father! Back to the Future.
Oh, no!
The cops are gonna pull you over all night, Marty. You can't drive this DeLorean. You're gonna get shot, and someone's gonna kneel on your neck.
Is the origin of Martin Luther King?
Oh no!
Marty,
party. You're gonna have a dream tonight. Stop fucking all these side chicks. Your wife is gonna find out and the FBI is gonna shoot you.
Martin Luther King's picture starts disappearing in front of Lincoln Memorial.
What the fuck?
Marty. We gotta shoot this movie.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, this is awesome.
And with that, let's go to scorekeeper Andy. Wow. See how we're doing after the first round.
He's crying.
That was such bullshit.
Oh my god.
That was great, guys. I'll see y'all tomorrow.
How many rounds are there? Yeah.
That's it, right?
Alright, so after the second round.
Holy shit, look at these Canadians! You
feel like Team Personality is in third
but
place with number 4.
But if you pencil in the exchange rate, they're losing.
Team Sex Appeal is in second with 10 points, and god damn it, the Knuckleheads are in first place.
With 22 loonies.
Canadian pesos. Our healthcare is leading the way.
That's 11 toonies.
All right, let's keep this moving right along.
Roll up money.
America has a... got it, Stevie. Just wait for everybody to be finished talking.
Like, oh, hey, do you have a Wayne Gretzky?
America has an accomplished and intense...
A couple of Bobby Nystroms.
Moving on to the next round.
Oh, shit, next round. Here we go.
All right.
She rules with an iron fist.
America has an accomplished and intense history. Cover it all would be quite difficult. A much simpler approach would be to just give you guys snapshots, or rather shots and other libations from each period. Annie, take it away and explain it to him.
Boy. All right.
Explain it to them.
Also, he's supposed to demonstrate, too.
Okay. No soy explain.
Oh, my God. It's so crazy.
All right. Starting with the team in first place and ending with the team in last. Teams will choose and consume the social lubricants from each era. Points will be given for style, speed, and commitment to the era. And the eras are colonial settlement, which is Jack. Pre-cum era, and then the post-cum era. The new nation, which is Jameson. And new, which is Absolute and Cranberry.
Let's do this. That's a lot of liquid.
So do 3 shots. I'm
getting. Oh yeah.
Take 3 shots of alcohol.
So first place, what do you?
yeah, that seems.
You guys only have to do 1, right?
3. Yeah.
Okay, so what do you guys want for your
colonial, please?
Colonial settlement, which is Jack.
Anthony Jameson.
I don't know, Lemire, what do you want?
Jameson?
All right, yeah, ready? Jameson. Colonial?
For me. Do you wait? Yeah. She doesn't consume the social lubricants from
each other. All right, ready?
Yeah, watch.
Jameson would be
ready?
They got 2 stunt doubles?
I'm confused. This is my country now, you fucking Indians.
Wow. Colonial. Get it? Colonial.
And so,
so there's no questions or anything? You just have to drink?
We took the land. Colonial. You get it?
I think I get it.
That's disappointing. Jameson. I thought there was some skill to this.
Bobby Jameson for we had to Anthony.
Chug drinks and smoke joints. We just have to take a shot now?
Just a shot.
And it's not
vodka.
Time against anything? I don't get it.
No. It's vodka and cranberry.
All right.
Thanks. Jameson. Hey.
Man, cheers.
You're Steve, right?
Well, I'm seriously rethinking our friendship.
That's
Lemaire. Rethinking our friendship after today.
Do we go? Oh, shit, we go.
Lemaire looks like a bodyguard.
Yeah, no shit.
We're training Patrice's.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow. There you go.
Wow.
Is this just to keep him occupied?
Wow. Thank God tomorrow's Friday, am I right?
Oh, shit.
Oh, wait, what?
Different day.
You have to. Oh, I still have to.
All right.
Gavin will carry me tomorrow.
Let's go to scorekeeper Andy and see how he feels about that physical challenge.
Yeah. Marty, the rest of the musicians are black too. You're going to have a great concert at the Enchantment Under the Sea Dance. Marty, no matter what, don't try and swim.
This is your cousin Marvin. We're being oppressed.
It's your cousin Marvin Berry. Yeah, wait till you see the girl that shits on his glass table.
Apparently he liked that kind of.
Also, make sure you shit at a different booth in the diner.
Oh, where did Andy go? That's what I wonder. I need
the
to
scorekeeper,
see
Andy.
All right, at the end of round three.
Wait a minute. What
shot?
We got it. We were at four. We were at 11.
Smile and enthusiasm.
This is America.
I'll take it.
This is America. We do whatever we want with these scores.
Yeah.
At the end of round three.
Thank you, better looking E-Rock.
Oh my God!
He looks like E Jock.
Yeah.
Yeah.
E Cock.
All of them are right.
E Frock.
Look, it is.
It was me, E Rock, and it reenactment on Forensic Files.
Yeah. At that point in time, he shot up the iHeart radio station.
His body was full of cum. second E-Rock. Place, team personality with 11 points.
Woo.
And in first place, the Knuckleheads. And I'm starting to believe in socialism.
Yeah. Ooh, those numbers are everywhere.
So much,
like COVID numbers, man.
Yeah.
How about no vaccines for you motherfuckers?
I'm good.
Probably work out just.
Team Canada, how are you guys feeling? You having fun?
Pretty good. I feel like I have a secondhand high.
Happy you came into the city? Worth
no.
it.
Are you having a heart attack?
Yeah, of course I'm happy. I'm having a great time.
Ryan, you seem to have gone quiet. You doing okay, buddy?
Am I quiet? I'll take another Trulies. Do you guys have any people for that?
Sure.
Yeah, we will grab that.
Can I get a water also? Can I get a water?
Wow. I have a Truly.
Right now, Jennifer seems like she's worried her career is history. So we'll move on to our next segment, which is American history.
Oh, great. Oh.
X!
Ooh, X!
I'll take! Right. I'll take curb stomp for 3 points.
I'll take systemic racism.
Critical race theory.
No, I mean, I'll take systemic racism.
I'm going American history XXX. Basketball.
All right, let's start with the first question. Okay, so you guys, where was the original capital of the USA? Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., New York City, or Richmond?
Oh, shit.
Shut up.
Philly, Washington, New York, Richmond. I thought this was easy.
Questions are supposed to get harder as they go on. This seemed to have stumped everybody.
No.
Wow.
Okay. I don't know. I think that's like the fucking...
I had to know them at the immigration's office. That's why I was like, fuck it.
Philadelphia.
All right, Anthony, we'll go to you guys first. What do you guys have?
Yeah.
Philadelphia. That's where
the murderous city in the world.
Killing motherfucker. Philadelphia.
Three times
the game is right
there. Team sex appeal. Team sex appeal. What's the answer?
Remember when they blew up the moon?
And let's go to Team Knuckle.
We're going to go with the cream cheese.
Cream cheese?
Oh, delicious.
Philadelphia.
Beautiful.
Philadelphia, let's see the answer.
What's the matter?
Obviously Philadelphia.
We're having the right answer.
Philly.
Yeah, questions are
I want to win, God damn it.
This seems a little bit easier. Who was our tallest president?
What? Who was the
tallest president? Was it James Madison, Abe Lincoln, Grover Cleveland, or Barry Obama?
He was definitely
Barry Obama.
He can talk.
Oh my God.
Ironic that you asked.
Barack Obama seemed a lot taller on the radio.
You ever see Smokey the Bandit? It's hilarious.
It's gotta be Abe, right?
No, definitely Barack.
What?
Them, though.
It's been mentioned a lot of times throughout.
Honest Abe.
Every history
book. Barack Obama.
Yeah, that's right.
He could dunk.
That's true.
All right, we'll go to...
Also had an afro.
Canada, Team Canaco.
This is a trick question, because if you consider wearing the hat, it would be Abe Lincoln.
God damn it.
Oh. But without the hat, it is the man that married the other man, Barack Obama.
Whoa!
Wow. That was very uncalled for. Team personality?
It was Abraham.
All Abraham right.
Lincoln. About sex appeal, what do you guys have?
Good old Abe.
Abe Lincoln.
Ooh, Abe Lincoln. Let's like go to the answer.
Of
course.
Oh my God! Did you actually put Barack Obama?
Are you out of your mind? What the scores end up being?
Put our points up.
Dunk
in the booth. Put our points up.
That was just the second question, Jennifer. We got three more rounds.
You gotta shoot him like this.
Three more.
You're crazy.
I'm sorry.
Tall. Also being the tallest guy and wearing an 8-inch hat.
Yeah, and he was sitting down. Good point.
Being the tallest president's like being the hottest chick at Compound.
Oh, oh, shit.
Oh, Luby, let me.
And by that, you mean Gino Visconti.
Yeah.
Well, he's the hottest lesbian. He doesn't count as a chick.
That is true.
If you I would like to ask the
you watch Bill Schultz walk away, he kind of looks like Trailer Trash Little Girl.
He does.
I'm like a sexy Billy G.
He does have
G.
a
King.
Fucking...
My hair's got still wet, Billy G.
You got a little sachet, you fruit.
Moving on to question number three.
Question number three.
Who was the first president to live in the White House? George Washington, Andrew Jackson, Abe Lincoln, or John Adams?
I know every fucking one of these, and I'm sitting on the bleachers.
Really, really upset.
I'm not looking. I'm not cheating.
Now, John Adams was a phony election, so it doesn't really matter.
Doesn't count then. I'm sorry.
Oh, we got the answer.
Nice. Yeah?
Mayor knows a lot about history, bro.
Ah, good.
Mayor.
This is my country.
George Washington.
I live here too.
Jackson.
I didn't know that at all.
God damn it.
I was
Land of the fucking free.
All right.
Yeah. Knowing facts is not going to make them give you stuff.
All right, Team Canada, are you ready?
Is this the shit that's on the immigrant test?
We're.
That was your fucking. Did you just grab your immigrant test, Luby, and be like, hey, here's what fucking.
No, this is
hey,
exactly what happened.
Don't know it. Yeah. Leave. America, love it or leave it.
Absolutely.
We're going to go with the guy that's on the $2 bill, Andrew Jackson. B.
Damn it.
Queer as a
personality. What do you guys have?
Same fucking thing, like for every other question.
And go to Team Sex Appeal.
We have the same thing.
Andy Jackson.
Andrew.
All right.
Same answers.
And the answer is John Adams, you guys. John Adams.
Once again, John Adams.
Oh, second, motherfucker.
It's John Adams.
First of the losers.
Is that George Washington holding a bazooka?
We're not all on the same team.
Yes, it is. Oh, okay. That, nothing more
John
American
Adams?
Than that.
It was
John. John Adams. Jim right. Heimerschmidt.
Let's move on to the next question.
Marty, don't go to Chicago. They're killing people like crazy.
And the first lady, Morticia.
Adams.
Adams, thank you. Wow.
Played by Nina Ricci.
Holy fucking. Is there a question about the atomic bombing?
Oh, fuck.
Wow.
All right, moving on.
All
right, Chip.
Who was the first president to be impeached? Was it Andrew Johnson, Andrew Jackson,
Donald Trump,
Bill Clinton, or Donald Trump?
It was Trump like four times.
No.
It's Andrew wish Johnson. You had me right now,
that's
Kumia.
That's the trick, Steve.
I have a beat on the street that it's Andrew Johnson.
Andrew Johnson.
We're going to go with that.
Don't
Andrew
mention
Johnson.
What happened in Times Square.
Gay sex.
A beat on
a lot
the
of that.
Street.
I think this one's Andrew. Elmer,
I did not impeach that man.
Dave, do you know?
You had a president.
You seem like you know the answer. Am I right?
I know it.
You seem like you're ready. No.
No, I don't know. I don't really know off. Shit about
eater,
politics.
Cheater, fucking syrup eater.
Johnson.
All right.
Cheater, cheater, Johnson. Syrup eater, cheater.
Oh yeah.
Your personality, Steve.
Andrew Johnson is exactly the answer.
Come on, Canada. You know the answer. What's the answer?
Yeah, we went with A for Andrew Johnson.
And that,
I didn't think he was real.
But that's the right answer. Andrew Johnson is the answer.
Andrews Johnson.
Never heard of him.
Oh.
Yeah. I got my citizenship.
Andrew Johnson, the first black president.
What if he's scoring accurate?
Johnson
and
is
he
the black president.
Andrew.
Holy shit. Look at fucking.
I just applied.
So I can do that. Is that Washington?
What
Holy
year no, was Andrew Johnson yeah. president?
That's Andrew Johnson.
Second amendment right there.
Well, just like everyone, if you get caught.
Final question of this round.
Yeah, it's just not as
very final.
Yeah, it looks like a halo.
I mean, what if I commit? I don't want to
like most of the rappers
here.
Now. You know,
yeah.
Like,
yeah.
The gun is all gay and effeminate.
Final question, guys.
I got my chopper.
Which building?
Do ya?
All right. So, which building in the USA has its
my
own?
My dick.
Nice.
Has its own zip code. Which building has its own zip code? Not Ryan's dick, please.
Do we have multiple choice?
No.
No, we just got to end with it.
Probably.
That would make sense.
Think buildings.
I'm not going to yell it out because I don't know, but here's some choices.
This should be.
That makes sense.
But it's gotta be something else.
Okay.
Oh wow, everyone's ready.
Jesus Christ.
Right, Jennifer, you can start
with that. We're going with the Juggalo Manor.
Juggalo Manor.
Okay then, Team Canada, I guess. Team Canada, what's your answer?
We are going to go with the place that Chrissy Mayer stormed on the 6th. Yes. The Capitol building.
God. Oh, wow. Oh, personality?
The Capitol.
Why hasn't anyone here turned her in?
The Pentagon.
Good cast.
Pentagon?
Pentagon has its own zip code.
The Pentagon.
All right. And Team Sex Appeal? They're panicking. What's happening? The White House. It's the Empire State Building.
Motherfucker! I was
thinking that was
gonna be another one. It got it in 98.
Is that like the Empire State Building?
10188 is the zip code for Empire State Building.
Yeah,
Empire State Building.
King Kong.
That concludes history.
Come on, Andy, give us a score. 112,
go fuck yourself.
Zip code.
Wow.
Angry guys. Always
for
been
a moment, I thought you were talking about
zip code. And that's coming from me. You broke
Wait,
my
how do you lose points?
We didn't broke fucking get any goddamn points.
Oh,
holy.
My God. We're winning. You guys.
Wait. You lose points?
Sex appeal.
This is crazy.
What the hell?
No, it's not. It's fair.
Oh, this is fine.
You are. That is a disaster way to die.
At the end of round three.
It looks really stable.
Seriously.
It looks really stable.
We got the
I saw this fall earlier.
Team personality 11 and team sex appeal 23.
Yeah.
Beer pong,
this looks super stable.
How fast things turn when they take points away.
Compound Media just turned into the Nelk Boys all of a sudden. Oh,
is that a Canadian thing?
What does that mean?
No idea who the Nelk Boys are.
Ryan, if you reveal who I rip off,
frat
I can't keep ripping them off.
Okay, we call them bro dudes.
No, they're
frat boys.
Run.
Gay fags.
Assholes.
Hey, listen, I don't mean to bring up references of people that got famous in the last 5 years. That's on me.
Oh, he just fucking gave you some.
You're old, Steve.
Dude, I got fucking nailed it. I don't even know why.
You totally. I'm joking because you haven't been famous for 5 minutes.
Exactly.
You got fucking smoked, dude.
I'm fucking dying over
You're
here.
You're in the target, homie.
Hey, Ryan, so, if you could stop revealing the guys I'm ripping off, it would make me ripping them off a lot easier.
Oh, now it's on you.
Stop revealing my sources. Yeah, I definitely saw a couple of their videos. I was like, that's a good idea. Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, okay. So this is a big rip-off.
I actually never knew this. I'm a little offended. It's okay.
All right. Well, if you ask any foreigner about America, it's not long before they bring up weight. They claim Americans will eat anything. This challenge tests those limits. Let's go to Manny and Mark to explain Putrid Pong Party.
All right. Putrid Pong.
Words.
Each team has been provided with ping pong balls. Teams will alternate volunteers to shoot at the pong cups. And each cup is a food ranging from enjoyable to disgusting.
Oh, God.
The team will then consume the food.
Wait, if we make it in, we gotta eat it?
Yeah.
So just miss.
Mark is gonna do it first.
Oh.
Okay. Wait, clarify, if you make it into the other team's cup, they have to eat it, right?
No, whatever you make, you eat, because there are good things.
That's also very far away.
I'll lose.
Ping pong balls fly.
You have to aim for what looks good.
You want the other team to eat.
You have to.
All right, just pretend you made one, Mark. We're gonna let it go.
Wow, it is.
If he makes one, who's
he? His girlfriend at the carnival.
What is it? What is it?
It's okay. She's running the roundabout.
You can bring it back.
Is it?
Oh my God! It's a sardine.
Oh God.
Ew.
Oh no! That's all you, dog.
Yeah, I can't.
Eat it, Mark. Eat it, Mark.
Oh, oh, oh.
Don't do it, yeah.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
he pretends.
No, you got it. Oh. Why? I'm going to eat it, you pussies.
These
are
my the boat trip over.
Oh, shit. Fuck. It's a fucking sardine.
It's the wee good.
Pull up.
All right, so we'll take turns.
That's when I saw her shoot sardine.
Each team has to make one and eat one cup. From where you're sitting.
Oh.
Thank you, guys.
Oh, Mayor, give him some ping pong balls.
What the fuck is going on? Marty, don't go down on your mom. She's ovulating.
And Luba's going to do the final ball.
You're eating your own egg, Marty.
Luba's going to be doing the final ball out of her pussy.
I got one. First try. I got one. Woo. Team Sex Appeal. Oh, what the heck is this? Woo. It's like raw.
This isn't mine.
It's like raw. Oh, no, balls are flying. It's like raw. It's raw pink meat.
Spam. Spam.
It's what?
Spam.
Oh, it's spam.
I just opened it. It's fresh.
Oh my god, I love this guy.
Oh, one went in. I think one went in there.
There, you get to eat a sardine.
That's not a bad one. No, no, no. I cleaned up that
over here.
No, 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 no.
You brat.
Oh, yeah. Oh my god.
There, please don't.
This is holy, holy balls.
Oh, yes.
Bill Schultz is throwing balls over here. I guess his mouth is full.
I got the middle one. Got the middle one. Oh my god. Guys, look at his head.
He's not even involved.
No.
It's just fully in him.
But you got it.
All of the Reese's.
Someone just threw a box of ping pong balls at Bobby.
Shit.
Bobby was getting abused there for a moment. Yeah.
Is Bill Schultz shooting him out of his ass, cheating?
It's a lot easier when the
Bill's ass came down.
Bill's ass can't hold a ping pong ball anymore.
Somebody turn on Hot for Teacher and make Bill Schultz spit these out of his asshole.
Who ate the spam?
Pulls out.
You just have this turn into a prolapsing his joke.
No, he also has a racket in there.
No!
Yes!
By the way, do you like how?
I think we won.
Tried out sorority girl. Killing it. Killing it. Tried out sorority girl on the bear pong.
Let's go to scorekeeper Andy.
He totally planned that.
That is goddamn.
Right, reminds me of when I broke the desk.
I readjusted the scores, but the kick didn't land last time. Anyway, so at third place, Team Sex Appeal with 18, Personality with 19, and in first place, Knuckleheads 25.
We got a bunch of Reese's.
I want a recount.
They were like 3 points each.
Are you eating? Jennifer, are you eating spam?
I'm eating Reese's.
We eating Reese's?
I got.
That's sorry. Taking the tits out for some beads. Come on.
Why are you not wearing those, Ryan? I gave them to you.
I'm not gonna remember it.
Respect America.
It can happen if you don't remember it.
Please respect America. You don't want to do it?
Big jelly guy?
Jesus Christ.
Jelly?
Hey, Bill, I'm writing a strongly worded letter to your non-human resources department.
What do we do now?
All right, you guys just ate some food. Now let's answer some questions about it in this segment. Food.
Food.
Oh, cool.
Okay. First question. Until 1990, McDonald's used something else instead of oil to fry French fries.
Wait,
was it?
Did you say 1990?
Peanut oil, beef fat, or cornstarch?
The blood of immigrants, I believe it was.
Oh, I believe that's when you were still under. Was it Ray Kroc's semen?
Ruby, how dare you say something wrong? This is coming your way.
Dear Bish America, Ryan. This is my home.
Oh my god.
I'm
going to
go with C and D.
Team Canucks looks puzzled.
Are you guys ready?
What the fuck they're using now? I don't.
Not even close?
Yeah, none of these mean anything now to me.
Come on.
I don't know.
It could have been.
I believe they used to use Wendy's pussy juice. mascot for Wendy's.
How did you know?
It was so wet.
God, that's amazing.
I think they use Jerry Curl now.
Yeah.
Jennifer, you seem ready. Let's start with your answer.
Dave, you know what? What's the stuff that people put in there?
We're gonna go with cornstarch.
Ron always gets to always.
Yeah, Ron, you're going bald.
McDonald's fries and pork.
Yeah, yeah. Our answer is C.
Fiber spray.
Beef fat.
I'm gonna find out.
Team personality. What do you guys have?
Got pork.
Yeah.
All right, and the right answer is beef fat.
Motherfucker!
It made it delicious.
Fat.
Oh. It made it delicious.
It's also what I call my wife's pussy lips during the special time.
Yeah. Beef fat.
Let me get some of that beef fat.
Lemaire, this next question's for you. How many ingredients does a Twinkie have?
Lizzo.
Is it 17?
How many ingredients?
27, 37, or 77?
How many ingredients Twinkie has? God,
all of these are disturbing.
I can tell you how much
you know
cum is in a twink.
And the last age you can be a twink.
Yeah, the upper bound for being a twink and the lower bound.
Yeah, my natural decision is to just say A.
17.
Because it's
the right
three
answer.
Higher than the number I would pick.
Oh, Anthony.
All right.
All right, Team Canada, what is your answer?
We're going to go with B.
I think it's the highest.
Yeah, 827?
Yeah, yeah.
Personality?
77.
All right, and Team Sexapale.
Pretty stupid.
27. Let's go to the answer.
It's 77. That's a lot of ingredients.
37.
Prove it.
Bald hairspray is called.
Don't feel bad. Luby got that one wrong, too.
Why is there a McDonald's logo for
20? That makes no sense.
That's a funny name.
That's a full glow.
Moving on, you guys.
No, it was
Activator.
Sheen.
Beijing.
Beijing.
I didn't hear the eagle graphic again, the transition.
Why would they call it Beijing?
That's what it's called.
Jet black. It was a Chinese thing, though.
Yeah?
Oh, now you know.
From the Chinese. By force.
All right, yeah, question amazing. Number three.
All the basketball players. There was a few that like would show up. They were bald the next day, and they showed up full head.
Like full head of spray hair.
Dripping. It's always dripping.
Oh, all the other players got like fucking shit on their arms.
So fucking funny, dude. Beijing.
Me and Aaron are gonna show up with spray hair next week. So they're gonna show
yeah,
up.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
All right, let's go to question number three. The reason why we're playing this song.
Oh, it's Jimmy Buffett.
Who invented the hamburger? Was it Johann Georgenheimer, George Washington Carver, Louis Lassen, or Thomas Crabbe?
Canadian hamburger!
Cheeseburger in paradise.
Crapper, wait. I know Thomas Crapper.
Crapper invented the toilet, if I'm not mistaken.
Crapper invented the chili dog.
Crapper, that's so funny.
That's where a woman shits on a man's penis and then sucks it off.
Thomas.
Chili dog. Thomas Crapper.
And you gotta give prompt when he's doing it. You go, Tommy.
Like a German.
Johann Georgia.
All right, let's start with Team Canada.
Thomas Crapper.
Is the answer Adolf Hitler?
All right.
All right, go with it.
Hey.
Adolf Hitler.
Adolf Hitler.
Oh,
good.
Hey.
Jennifer, Team Sex Appeal, what is the answer?
Jennifer,
you guys have the answer? Am I?
A.
All right. A. And Team Personality?
Should we do C?
It's okay. Just let it be.
We're all
C if it's right, but A is what we originally picked.
And let's go to the answer.
You think you're contrarian.
Like the C.
Yes! Oh! We got that! We done got that! A circle the one I actually picked.
Luby, I'd like to rage an infraction.
The last minute.
I'd like to bring an infraction. You can't have two guesses on the same page, so I want that to go to the video judges.
That's correct.
That was the last one. So.
And in Canada, we'll take it to the Human Rights Tribunal.
And if you check.
Aaron, where did you get your hat that says tax the poor?
InHotWaterStore.com.
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, how much did you fucking make for that?
Yeah.
Wow.
Thanks, Jan.
Wow, the plug.
There you go. There you go. You're welcome. Anyway, any other plugs? Any other plugs?
Do you have guns available, Aaron?
I have you can catch on my merch store, Tax the Fat.
Email Dan at X-Ring 3. The In Hot Water AR-15 is now available.
I love this.
Not even joking.
Not joke.
Who the fuck made guns merch?
Yeah.
You guys.
Thank you.
It's crazy.
Thank you.
Especially in this day and age.
Yeah.
When you need them the most.
Right.
In these times.
If you shoot someone with an In Hot Water gun and it goes to court and they look up In Hot Water, you're fucking in prison for life.
Well, you also need to get them to understand
popular
that it's an In Hot Water gun and not an In Hot Water gun.
Water gun. Yeah.
No, if you thought it was a hot
water gun.
Hot water.
Oh, just water guns and not real water.
I didn't know. I thought it was a water gun.
I paid $2,000 for this.
Oh, shit. All right, question number four.
That's fucking brilliant.
That was amazing, honestly. I never thought
40.
Was
when other people drive by your house with guns out the window, duck real fast.
Marty.
All right, Bill Schultz, that was the AR-15, or as Bill Schultz calls it, the AR. I was sure she wasn't 15. So
that was wordy. And not appreciated.
16.
Not appreciated. Editor.
All right, question number four, everyone. When was pumpkin pie?
I got a question.
Pie? When was pumpkin pie?
Can someone get me a cold beer?
Of course.
What? Oh, the answer is of course. All right.
The answer is you, Luby.
The answer is of
cold
course.
Beer.
Hey.
Wow.
How y'all gonna sit here and ask questions about pumpkin pie? Don't nobody know shit about pumpkin pie. Can we get a question about Sadiq? This test is biased. I don't want to take it off the back.
Oh, my God.
These questions.
Was it... Does it predate America, first Thanksgiving, second Thanksgiving, or Juneteenth?
When was pumpkin?
It's awesome. Predates America. First Thanksgiving, second Thanksgiving.
Juneteenth.
Fuck. Oh my god. I think it was Juneteenth, honestly.
Oh my god.
Can't just throw Juneteenth in the fucking mix.
What happened there?
God damn you people. Why do you make racism so funny?
God bless you people. God bless. God damn you people.
We didn't land on Juneteenth. Juneteenth landed on us.
Oh my
That's what happens when Juneteenth and the gay parade.
My makeup is completely ruined. So, Team Canada, what is your answer?
I feel sorry for Juneteenth. What'd you say about Juneteenth? Oh, shit.
She said you got C an minus?
Oh, shit.
C minus?
Just C.
C. Okay.
C. Okay.
The second Thanksgiving, or as the Indians called it, still no more blanketums.
Okay, team personality, what is your answer?
A. There was pumpkin pies before there was America's.
All right. Team sex appeal, what is your answer?
Mm-hmm.
We're going to say B.
And then America brought over.
All right, let's go to the answer. Was the second
answer. You guys are fucking cheating.
They even
you know the pumpkin pies did so much fucking.
Anyone ever tell you pussy tastes like pumpkin
pie? The color of the skin went from white to orange.
I will have one of those Chesterfields.
Oh my
god. All right, let's talk about pizza.
I don't think they could possibly
know. What are we talking about?
So how much pizza do Americans consume a day?
No multiple choice. This is insane.
No.
Gillion, zillion, begillion.
That's the fun of it.
Fuck. 100 slices?
Pies.
Fucking. Are you out of your
million.
Mind? How do you not make this multiple choice?
It's down to the decimal point.
Is it slices, pounds, what?
I get it. Okay. Are you like crazy? That's a very good answer. That's a very good answer.
Get creative. That's the point. Come on.
What do you want it in? What measurement?
Let's say...
Canadian metric?
Give it to us in Bitcoin. American. American. We want it in American.
American metrics.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
What do you want it in? Pounds?
American. Probably right.
American.
American what?
American.
America.
Oh.
American.
I know what this means.
American metrics.
This is like
please.
The SATs. Just write your name.
All this ambiguous talk about pizza. What is she, Hillary Clinton?
Oh!
Child porn, I think.
Cheese pizza.
And why don't we also talk about some hot dogs?
Oh, that's spaghetti with the meatballs.
Hey, yeah, that's the...
How controversial. Oh, my goodness.
Can we get some meatballs in here? A really fucking fat 12-year-old.
Oh, my gosh.
Italian 12-year-old.
Oh, my gosh. Ryan, you're way too sexual.
What a Rain Man question is this?
And I don't appreciate it. You're too sexual for my taste. For
please give him some.
Team Canada, what's the answer? Team Canada, you can't.
Lots.
I think that they're out of ideas.
I also want to say that I think they ate enough pizzas.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Enough pizzas.
For show.
Okay, team personality.
I'm gonna credit Lemaire with the scientific answer. 1.5 slices a day. On average, if you average out your week of pizza.
Capita?
0.5 a day.
A discredit to your race.
What am I, a fucking not get a beer guy?
You think people are gonna
have it? Oh my god.
Yeah, what are you?
And
Team Temple
sex appeal.
Come on, man.
1 million per day.
Come on, man.
1 million per day. Let's
We found out it's not that the Americans eat
100 acres. 100 acres worth of
pizza. All right, well, is our calculation sort of right, too?
Dude, are you out of your mind? It's a
acre.
It's a...
We need that.
It's an actual area question and not a slice question. It should have been how much...
Oh, no, well...
That is an unanswerable question.
All right. Our answer 1 million was square feet, which equals 100 acres.
Yes. You better, oh, you better fix that
question. Alex Trebek's pancreas is rolling in its grave right now.
Oh, my God.
All right, let's go to scorekeeper Andy for the results.
All right, first place. Well,
you're right, fuck them.
Team Knuckleheads with a very powerful 125 points.
No, it bothers me.
In second place, Team Personality, 119 points.
By the way, this is sexist.
And in third place, but still in it, Team Sex Appeal with a hot 18.
Can we give half our points for reparations?
Yeah.
What the fuck is this?
Modelo.
Was there not a Budweiser in
Modelo,
there?
Mexican for piss.
Are you saying you don't know or no?
It's actually not bad on a hot summer day on a beach with like a little bit of lime.
This is the second worst thing you've ever done in this.
What's the first?
He broke my desk once.
This desk right here.
I actually had him fired and banned from the place. And somehow, someone let him back in.
Yeah, tight security here. Tight security here.
I feel like a chick watching football. Like, I don't know what's going on.
For letting me back here, so thank you. Thank you, Anthony Cumia, by the way.
You read that perfectly. Thank you.
What other promos do you have, Anthony? Quick, while he's at it. What are the promos? What are you promoing? What do you want to promo?
Oh, my Twitch account, A Cumia, Anthony Cumia.
Your OnlyFans account.
I play Call of Duty on Twitch, and there's nothing better than watching a man born in the 60s play video games. Thank you. I think it's real.
Yeah.
I think I'm actually remotely winning the nom.
For those of you, it's not children calling you the N-word.
No. You know, when I hear it, I do have hope for the youngsters. Of
Well, there isn't anything more American than that. Oh, there's not much more American than baseball. Helping your friends.
My God.
This challenge combines the two. Let's go to Manny so he can explain the dizzy bat dilemma.
Ooh. Oh, sweet.
Oh, and it's frozen.
Is it frozen?
I moved to this country to play baseball.
It's like a bong.
What are you doing in Spanish?
All right. RPG! Oh, it's a bong. I was going to just shoot.
One member of each team will hold a bong hit for as long as they can. However many seconds they hold the hit with the spin from the 30 spins your teammate
must do. And this will be done Steve-O style.
Yes, I cannot do it.
A second teammate performs the dizzy bat portion, consuming the beer from the bat, spinning 30 times, and then attempting to hit the ball.
If they hold it
for longer than 30 seconds.
No, this is crazier than any tried-out college
you
party
hold it,
I've ever attempted.
For longer than 30 seconds.
What's happening right now?
Hey, Garrett, we used to have a wiffle ball bat thing back on the ONA show.
All right, I'm going to jam the wiffle ball
in my fluid,
pussy.
Too. Yeah, jam it in your pussy.
My sorority sisters would be so proud. So proud right now.
Oh. Well, invite him over. We'll talk to him and see how
proud. I'm the only female on this all-male panel.
Five,
oh
my 6, God. 7, 8, 9, 10, woo! 12, 13, 14, 15.
Oh!
15 bat spins.
Oh, my God.
Are you doing
one. Now he does the bat spin for 15 seconds.
Bat spin. Here he goes.
Oh, shit.
What is that?
He filled it?
Wait a minute. I have to drink the bat? I thought I had to like spin with the bat.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, what's going on?
Can he have two balls to cup while he... Yeah, there you go.
It's like fucking calm.
Anyone bat?
Wow!
Oh, you gotta drink it then spin. Now I get it.
Oh my God.
Why is he demoing this and not on a team?
What's going on all over the floor? Great. We gotta work in here.
Wow. Did you actually tell him how many revolutions, or is he making it up as he goes along?
I could say I want no part of this.
Hold on.
What the fuck?
What the fuck?
Oh,
well,
shit.
Well, this is the grand finale. This is the big fireworks finish.
I think that was perfect.
We're going to do that.
So.
No, it's not. All right. Let's go, Team Knucklehead. You're going to drink the beer for and spin for as many seconds as he can hold it.
Part of the big acreage of pizza.
Yeah.
Jamaican bizarre.
They're like
and a mule.
Yeah.
Well, he's doing both at once.
Schultz could have deep throated that bat. Oh, here he goes. Look at this.
I want to see Schultz do it.
Yeah.
Schultz, you need to drink out of the baseball bag.
This guy's real good at smoking weed. God. I was here for the last one of these things, and he smoked a whole bunch of weed.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
God.
Uh-oh. Wow. Whoa.
Damage your brain already did.
Hey, man.
23 seconds.
Wow. Wow.
You only got to spin 7 times.
Wait, what?
Good job.
Oh, yeah.
That's the 30?
It's subtracted from the 30. Oh. Now I get it.
He held his breath longer than Shatner's wife.
Well, what do you do? You're doing the bong or the spin?
She drowned. It was hilarious.
Just let him spin.
How come he never yelled, I can't breathe?
It's going to be 29 spins.
Yeah, this is going to be a problem.
You got to put your forehead on it.
All right.
Oh, you gotta drink the fucking.
Drink the coffee.
Oh, yeah, drink and. Oh, my God.
Oh.
Nice.
Okay.
No.
No.
No. It's falling down.
No. Oh, I love it. Oh, fuck.
Oh, shit. Spill it. It's not.
Drink.
Oh, that's wrong.
Oh. Oh.
Fucking thing.
Yeah, that is tough. It's like one of those yard things that you get at a Renaissance fair.
Drink the mead, young man.
There's too much.
All right. Just like Jackie.
Mead out of
just like Jackie Robinson.
Beer for it.
Oh! Oh, he hit him right in the face. I love it.
Yeah.
Holy shit. Holy shit. Great teamwork.
That was freaking awesome. No, that was amazing. Stop breaking the chair.
I am lost here, but I'm watching.
I'm like a chick at the Super Bowl.
Yeah, why?
Everyone's having a good
what
time.
What happened? Everyone's... Everyone's having a good time.
Be around and celebrate.
What? I'm just... Yeah, I want to be around people laughing. I don't know what the fuck's going on, but... Oh shit!
This is what it must be like to be a good
man. Luby, is this how you smuggled out your savings?
Yeah.
Is this how you smuggled your money out of the Ukraine or I don't know where is it? From Montenegro. Oh! Oh shit!
Why does this look like?
Whoa! Here we go. There's my teammate. Steve. I hope that's your name. I don't know who these people are. I don't even sign their checks.
Oh my God.
Corporation does.
Oh my God.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, he had it
in there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow. Wait, wow.
What just happened?
I don't know, but it looked impressive.
That was really, like, I
that was amazing. That was good.
Steve, you okay?
Yeah. The last time a bat made that kind of an impact, it was in Wuhan. Awesome, dude. Awesome.
I think we won. I think that sealed the deal.
I think that fucking did it.
I think that was another 100 points.
Oh. We're looking at MAGA right here, by the way. A woman mopping. Oh, is that a wonder to see? Thank you, Luby. I came. Like a American flag Minnie Mouse. You ready to fall off the goddamn chair?
Funny.
I love it.
Here's how much I fucking.
All right, guys, come on. Come on, Team Sex Appeal. Woo woo!
Omaha is Nebraska.
Come on. Woo! Keep it going.
N-E, yeah.
Yeah.
You put N-P?
I guess.
Oh, no.
Woo! Team
Sex Appeal. I don't know what's in it.
You're the bingo. You're right.
Yeah!
Wow!
What did he do? Use the same technique that LeMaire used.
Yeah, yeah.
Pitch it!
You guys are so good.
What did you do? Good.
I was
blind. Oh my God. Go! Woo! Oh, what's happening? What?
Oh, swing and a miss! Swing and a miss!
Pathetic! Wow.
What a sad ending.
By the way, I love how I love how neither of my teammates consulted with me to do this. Like, they just knew.
That's what you better bet.
I think that's fair. I think that's fair.
Right.
Respect. There's a strike. The count is 2-2.
Woo! He's back. Great job.
Oh, my God.
Andy, give us the results.
Let's give him a few seconds to tabulate. That was a lot to take in.
Oh,
Jennifer, you having fun?
So much fun. I'm on my phone sending an email right now.
Oh, my God.
It's always a good sign when
I'm... Don't have a legal...
I'm emailing Bill Schultz. No, what? I'm sending a strongly worded letter to your non-existent human resources department.
I thought they only did that during sex. During sex.
Did you say, Anthony?
Yeah.
Did you say?
During sex.
Andy, give us, please, the score.
All right, Andy Malafrina, been in here the whole time.
Okay.
In third place, we got Team Sex Appeal, because someone fucked it up. In second place, Knuckleheads with 150. And in first place, Team Personality.
Whatever.
I would say this is almost as
sexist.
As you can go.
Very sexist.
Loss is winning. I love it.
Guys, Aaron Burke has to wake up at 7 in the morning tomorrow.
Let's wrap it up.
Just throwing that out there.
Well, we'll keep this rolling, Bill. Three things America does great: war, sex, and sports. This segment's all about sports.
No. I love the bomber. It was awesome.
Aaron's got to be here at 7. That vibe. You got to be on the
street. All right. This question is a little complicated, so listen carefully. From 1960 to 1966.
Oh,
1960 to 1966. Which NBA team? Thank you. Okay. Won 7 straight championships and still has the most championships total.
Oh my God.
60 to 66. Jesus. This is the white guy in those ridiculously mo-like short shorts.
Those were cute though. I like that.
It wasn't even basketball.
Yeah, they're playing baseball music.
Bump, 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 bump. This was. At the basketball game.
Adam.
He is American.
The basketball game. Take me out to that place. Let me watch the lanky white man bounce around a pumpkin-shaped nut and I'll yell.
Okay, the Lakers, Celtics, Sixers, or the Bulls? Anybody has an answer?
Yes.
Okay, personality.
You're not an American if you get this wrong.
It's a Canadian sport, just for the record, James Naismith.
Thank you, James.
You didn't
matter. Actually over 6'1".
Like me. Steve, what's the answer? The
answer was yes, basketball.
Yes. No, I...
Celtics.
Celtics.
All right.
I go with Celtics.
Team Sex Appeal? Are you ready?
We're gonna go with
Simon Short.
The longest
Celtics
out of any team.
Yeah. Canada.
B.
What's happening?
The Celtics.
Show us your answer. You're cheating.
Cheating.
Cheaters. Canada is cheating.
Show me the card.
Show us the card.
Cheating.
Show us the answer.
The answer first.
All right. The right answer is B. The Celtics. Yeah. That is the correct answer.
Ah, yeah, the Celtics.
Let's move on to question number 2.
From Boston, by the way, a little trivia. The most racist city in the country. Thank you.
Idaho.
They're very diverse, but they keep their diversity in different areas.
I'm glad I picked out those questions.
Hilarious.
That statement's almost as controversial as the designated hitter. And this next question is about baseball.
Oh.
Who won the first World Series? Who won the first World Series in 1903?
Oh, who gives a shit?
Who gives it? A, Boston, B, Pittsburgh, C, New York, or D, Cleveland?
1918! Oh, wait.
They won after that. Oh, was I heartbroken. Fucking Yankees.
Believe me. I recall.
We're being honest the whole time, but we're America. We cheat.
So yeah, what are they?
Jennifer, you can't Google answers.
I'm not Googling.
Okay, I'm just checking
an email.
Just checking.
The first World Series in 1903. I was born in 1990.
Just playing the.
How am I going to know this?
The answer last, since everyone just got these are correct answers.
But they won more than anyone, so
we will now be the Asian kids in crash.
Can I phone Bill Scholes?
It's in the fucking MLB in 1903.
Can I do the phone a friend option?
Ah.
All right, Team Canada, are you ready? ready.
It might be the Mets.
Oh, Bill Schultz is trying to assassinate Aaron Burr with a fucking ping pong ball.
Thank you.
You want to take care of him? You want to take care of that motherfucker?
1903.
The Idaho Klansmen.
I believe they won. Let's go.
Hey, Jennifer, what do you guys
with
have?
You?
I'm just going to go with Yankees.
All right.
Yankees.
In personality?
I do. I mean, just the odds.
The Yankees.
Just playing the odds. I'm not
Canada.
Sure. I don't think so, but
Boston.
Red Sox.
Boston. The right answer is Boston.
Come on.
Sorry.
Oh,
sorry. We said Boston.
Fuck your mother. Go fuck your mother.
What?
Cocksucker. You're all cocksuckers. Go fuck your mother. Fuck your mother.
You're garbage.
You're garbage.
I got a number.
Fuck you. Noma. Noma.
It's me who chose all the questions. Amazing.
That shit.
Okay, let's go to the fourth question. Sorry, third question. Most decorated Olympian of all time.
A lot of questions.
Most decorated Olympian.
They don't mean decorated like that.
Gayest Olympian.
Is that it?
Decorated. So like the most medals. Stop. Why wouldn't you put that? The most medals. Decorated.
We're trying to be fancy.
Yeah.
The most medals?
Yeah.
Simone Biles.
You need medals.
Yeah. I gotta go.
Ian Lofty.
Fucking guy.
Our answer is the next president of the United States, Bruce Jenner.
No, they didn't hear you.
We're gonna go with Michael Phelps.
Michael Phelps.
Bruce Jenner.
Bruce Jenner. Team personality, what is your answer?
Oh, it's this one. Michael Phelps.
Michael Phelps.
Michael Phelps.
And Team Canada said?
Bruce Jenner.
Bruce Jenner. Right answer is Michael Phelps.
Yeah! Yeah!
Got it down.
You
bitch.
That was
you.
America.
Thank God you guys went last on that one,
Aaron. Beat that Jew, Mark Spitz.
Whoa.
Was it the way I said Jew?
It's the way you said Spitz.
It's the beat. A Jew.
That Jew.
Mark Spitz.
Yeah.
Team Canada.
It's
defensive. I've made no racial jokes at all this evening.
Oh.
6 million wasn't enough.
Make it up to you, Aaron. We'll ask a question about hockey.
I live.
What was used to make the first puck?
Marty. Watch out for the Jews. They're going to ask for rent money.
Frozen cow. Oh, my God. I saw the last answer when they fucked up the thing.
Don't go back and kill baby Hitler.
Was it rubber, steel, rock, or frozen cow poo?
Oh.
I got this, guys.
Oh, come on. It's gone.
I can say
stupid tigs.
Yeah.
No, it would be D, but it's too obvious.
It is,
definitely
right?
Some other dumb shit.
All right. Yeah. I don't know.
Like rubber.
I'll give it to you.
So, Jennifer, let's start with you. Jennifer,
what's frozen cow poo?
Personality?
Can't you steal your hoser? Right? They say that?
Personality?
I'll roll up a toque.
The cow poop.
Yeah, we'll roll up and wet a toque.
Frozen cow poop.
It is in fact frozen cow.
Team Canada is. Okay, everybody knew this one.
How many cows?
Wow. It is frozen cow poop.
Oh my God, I thought it was going to be.
It really is, yep. Oh, disgusting yet true.
Well, you wrote that, right?
Okay, the next question is.
Oh, yeah.
What did Babe Ruth wear under his hat to keep cool?
Long.
A hot dog.
He wore something under his hat because he was hot all the time.
Oh,
what was it?
The blood of his enemies, I believe it was. Yes.
Close. Close.
What would he put under there? A fucking
ham hock.
Maybe some Beijing?
An Asian baby.
Beijing. We got it.
Yeah, yeah. There he is.
The first round.
You know,
I made that in.
The Sultan of Swat points. Keeps a.
Okay, you guys have to.
Baby embryo under his.
Try something.
This is one of those frozen tampons.
Paper towel, wet paper towel.
All right, so. Wet paper towel is your final answer, Team Sex Appeal?
A
paper towel is your final answer?
Yeah.
Okay.
What else?
Team personality?
Back then.
A pile of cold ham.
Fuck, they weren't smart.
Back in olden times. Cuts. It was ice.
He keeps cold cuts under
ice,
his
ice.
Cold
baby.
Cuts.
Man, ice.
The correct answer was schmegma,
Oh, a washcloth. We're going to go with washcloth.
A good old pile of penis gum.
If it was schmegma, he'd be
all right.
Like, I'm the luckiest man on the face of the air.
Paper towel?
Yeah.
All right, let's see the answer.
Cabbage leaf.
Fuck you. Oh, that's a wet paper towel.
Nobody knows what that is.
That is a 100 acres of pizza and a cabbage leaf.
That's what
they used to call black people.
No, that's a.
That's what Luby's people eat for dinner.
Two cabbage leaves just took my truck.
Racist goddamn oldie times.
All right, let's go to scorekeeper Andy.
Oh my
gosh. Moving on.
That's the worst.
Andy. What's the situation with the score?
Oh, Andy. Come on,
Andy.
Sorry.
Let's go!
So in third place, Team Sex Appeal. In second place, Knuckleheads. Let's and go. In first place,
let's go.
Team Personality.
Wow.
USA. Wow, but it USA. Is.
This is amazing.
This is tight. This is
all right. Nice. What a comeback.
Doing trivia wise. That's
what a comeback.
I believed in Compound this whole time. Boss, I knew they're going
to
do this.
And just to fuck it, I am going to be so happy.
I mean,
guys, the best part of America is the freedom.
They want to keep their job.
Freedom to say what I want, to do what I want, like bongs. You know what this section is? It's the physical challenge, bongs on bongs. And to get it started, we need to bring in some props. Let's bring in strength coach Andrea from Queens.
Andrea!
Oh!
Yay! Andrea! Oh,
this is a bucket of my own feces.
Well, what is that?
Yeah, whoop!
Andrea's on the East Side Dave show with Roy Harder every Tuesday, 7:30.
What's happening? I'm nervous. Is that a trash can full of water? Oh my
wow.
God.
It rolls out. Okay. This game, each team will have one member perform a beer bong and one perform a gravity bong. That's it. It's,
you're our closer on this one.
I'm going to do the gravity bong.
Stevie Lou?
I don't know.
Stevie Lou was amazing the last time. It was almost a little disturbing to watch him do it.
All
right, Luby. Oh, okay. When the I was wondering where the funnel would come in.
I'll do the funnel. I got the funnel.
Can someone go downstairs and get my wife?
My wife.
Uh-oh. Someone's already downstairs meeting your wife.
Yeah, it's,
oh! Those
crackheads. Send someone now.
All right.
What? It's funny. The crackhead could joke about someone fucking another man's wife, isn't it? Isn't it hilarious? And isn't it only fucking funny when you can do it with someone you know and as a friend? If you just went on a subway and go, hey, this guy fucking your wife, you probably get punched in the fucking face.
Subway? I did that once and I had no idea
It's so offensive. It's so fucking offensive.
Watch this.
I was at a baseball game and everybody was just being belligerent, right? And somehow I just got into the groove of that.
Oh,
and then
no.
Some new guy came. He was a part of the group, but he didn't know me.
Yes.
And they introduced him to me, and I just go, fucking your wife tonight.
Oh, shit.
And then he just double checked and goes, did you say you're fucking my wife? Like, yeah. Don't worry about that.
Think he was, think it was funny?
Don't worry.
I don't know what the hell I thought.
Because it seems like you weren't even trying to make him laugh. You
just remember
being an asshole.
Yeah. And I remember people came later like, hey,
Steve,
did you tell
what
him?
What are you doing?
Yeah. Like, they laughed. They laughed.
Oh, no. You made him leave.
Dude, that's hilarious.
Definitely like, they got there, the worst?
It's literally the worst thing you could say. Unless it's a close friend, which is the weirdest thing. If it's the closest friend, it's funny as fuck.
Drinking or
you don't know the person? Yeah. It's literally the worst thing you can say. How does that work? It's like magic.
I think the only thing that I had going for me was I was a big black guy.
Let's just get out of here.
Perhaps someone is fucking.
Oh, yeah.
Well, perhaps he is.
The shit out of me. Those are fighting words.
That's
those are fighting words.
Either we gotta leave or you gotta watch me get beat up, lady.
Yeah. Wait, what'd you say?
Now, what's the.
Drink or smoke?
Oh, I'm smoking.
I'm drinking, yeah.
There we go.
We go first? No, they go first.
I ain't fucking doing no funnel shit.
Don't worry, boss. I got the funnel.
I've done that shit, and it is awesome.
What about the gravity bong?
Gravity bong? What? There is no gravity. The earth is flat.
I know that.
You dunce.
The saddest part is I have to clean up everything after this.
What is your brain made of squirrel droppings?
What is that? It's shaped like a contact lens.
Tissue paper?
Stevie Lou.
Here we go.
Stevie Lou. Stevie Lou. Stevie Lou. Come on.
Yeah, do the thing. Come on, man, you know.
Wow. Every accomplishment here just proves what more of a piece of shit he is. It's not like, I'm not going, wow, that's impressive. That builds respect. I go, oh, wow, you are about a piece of shit. All respect. All respect.
Respect.
All due respect, my friend. You're doing a great job for the wrong team, but I appreciate it.
All right.
I have faith in these two boys. Come on, guys.
I like the cop word for it. They're like, oh, I was fucking banged up last night. Banged up is such a great way to put drunk.
Dinged up. Yeah, I was
banged up. That's when they pull out and give you the wood shampoo. I don't know what's going on. I just saw this. Here we go. What do you got? What do you got? Is there a valve on the bottom of that? What high-tech funnel shots?
Serious.
There it is. Oh! Graviton. Gravity's awesome.
All right. Great job, Steve.
America, get it, baby.
Yeah, once you get there, it starts fucking. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Oh, shit. Who's doing that? Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right?
He's got two.
Now for the news. There's fentanyl in that.
I did it in two. We did it in three.
Your lungs are going to close up, but it's all right. The police will be here in a couple minutes to help.
Oh, no. God. Oh, shit.
Come on. No, please. Wow. He's going to pass out.
That was fucking
that
impressive.
That was it. Oh. Amazing.
A lot of smoke.
Dave Temple.
Damn. Fucking A, dude.
You have a that is job because he was really good, so you can't look weak.
The last time I did the gravity bong, it was the highest I've ever heard in my life. Yeah. Attaboy. That was fucking...
I'm pretty high right
I'm real
now.
Sweaty.
I'm
really yeah, that'll do it.
Wow, look at this frat house. What the fuck
happened
here?
A lot of people
what am I doing?
That'll
be right on. And then you know what happens after, right?
Oh, yeah, probably. Oh, yeah.
Yo.
That's definitely like.
Do it.
I gotta. Because I'll just
show off. Everything.
Oh, fuck.
Right.
Okay.
That's like a 1975 Playboy.
It's like an old Playboy
center.
Come on, Dave. Dave, I believe in you. I believe in you, Dave. Just let it all kind of just go out. Don't bother with it. It's a mess. It's a mess. Don't keep doing.
This is mind blowing.
We'd be like, we have to guess.
You're not ready to just be high like you don't care about life. Don't.
Everybody back to your seats.
It's too much weed. It's way too much weed.
Dave Temple, Jennifer.
Could you do it again?
Circular.
Like we're very.
Sexy people don't want to follow the rules. Okay, I get it.
What happened? Who won?
You can't control it.
All right. It's time for the final section of questions.
You got that?
Final round, you guys. Final round.
Steve, for me, buddy. Hold it. Attention. One last round.
Oh, my God.
My favorite part of America.
What?
This section is just simply, we're better than you.
All right.
Yeah, we're going to do this one a little differently.
We did Dave,
my philosophy. We're going to ask, all three questions. Write down all three answers, and then we'll get them all at the same time.
Now, why?
There's
you'll
a point.
See. Fast money. We're playing fast money.
We'll see. Ooh. Well, excuse me.
This question is.
You know you had some master plan I was not privy to.
You can't tell by this horrible thing.
Fire. No. Fucking tell me or you're fired. Nah. I love this game.
Okay. Which country produces the most nuclear power?
Tomorrow's Saturday.
Nuclear power? Which country?
Can't wait.
Yes.
Video games.
Question number two.
All day.
Are we getting anything else for you?
Awesome. Can you put it up, the question?
United States.
Can you put up the question?
United States of America.
America.
What?
Can you put up the question?
To run out of graphics? Where's the question?
Which country produces the most?
Oh, good decision with the background color.
Fonts couldn't be better.
Which country produces the most?
Cannot read that.
Nuclear power.
Who did this? They're fired.
Oh, I get it.
Julie, oh, you're done.
It's a simple question. Who produces the most nuclear power?
If I hear it, I can't read it.
Can you please request the eagle graphic again, the transition? I'm paying for that.
It's so great.
All right, so All right, I'm sorry.
I don't want to.
The most nuclear.
That was the problem, Luby.
That's not a country. That's a city in Russia.
Wait.
Okay, second question is, which country has the highest number of billionaires?
Oh my God, I get it.
The third question is, which country?
America.
Why?
Wait. Most billionaires?
United States of America. America.
Nuclear power.
As the most billionaires, America.
Of course.
Of course it is.
The final question. China. Which country donates the most to charity each year?
America. Every answer is America.
The black.
Hey, I have the appropriate answer to all three questions, Your Honor. USA. USA. USA.
Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Black Lives Matter. Say it. But I think all of them in the hand.
See the final answer, Drew.
What?
I'll take
Steve.
It.
Steve. Show us.
You got it right, Aaron. Let's go one last time to see who won. Scorekeeper Andy Malafarina.
Let's see the points.
We're going to pause 1 second. Everybody have fun. Aaron, thank you.
So much fun.
Brian, thank you. Stevie and Nate, thank you. Anthony, thank you for doing this and letting us do this in here. Lemaire, thank you for coming.
I didn't even know this was happening.
Steve, thank you.
Thank God tomorrow's Sunday.
Don't kill yourself.
Jennifer, thank you so much for putting up with it. Mike, thanks for coming out. Manny, you did a great job. Mark, you killed it. And as always, thank you to Bill Schultz for being the train wreck that he is naturally. Thanks to Drew and Garrett.
You find I'm here.
Andy Malafarina for keeping
score. Take that vaccine for that Air Force thing.
Well, let's see who won, I guess.
Marty, the bats.
Marty, I need you to go to Tuskegee.
The final scores are in, and Andy is not here to read them. But we have in last place Team Sex Appeal with 16-19. We got
so
in
rigged.
Second place Team Knucklehead 17-76.
Really like
and of course, our winners for the evening, Team Motherfucking Personality.
I feel like Stalin. When Stalin won the election. 80 times running.
Thank you all for watching.
The winner, America!
What a recount!
I'm on.
Six.
Good game.
Unbelievable.
Lordy, it's America.
We're gonna have a job selling loose cigarettes in Staten Island. It's very important when the officers come.
I'm gonna come.